Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Chemistry Basics. In last video we have seen that structure of amino acid, its definition and classification in details. Today we are going to see the properties of amino acids and reactions of amino acids in details. Before going to start today's video, first subscribe my channel and press the bell icon button so you'll get the notification of the next video. This video is somewhat lengthy, so you can watch this video by increasing the speed through settings. Okay, let's start the today's topic, that properties of amino acids. As amino acids consist of the amino and acid group, so it can show the properties of both amines as well as carboxylic acids. But some properties are somewhat different as compared to the amines and carboxylic acids. So let's see that properties. So first properties, all amino acids are optically active except glycine, because glycine do not have chiral center. That is already we have seen in detail in classification video. Okay, so all other amino acids that will definitely has a chiral center, and that's why they are optically active. Second properties, amino acids are water soluble and partially insoluble in organic solvent. If you are taking the long chain amines and carboxylic acids, they are mostly water insoluble, but amino acids are water soluble. And these long chain amines and carboxylic acids are soluble in organic solvents, but the amino acids are insoluble in organic solvent or partially insoluble in organic solvent. So they are showing somewhat opposite property as compared to the long chain amines and carboxylic acids. Third property, melting point of amino acids are very high as compared to the carboxylic acids and amines, because carboxylic acids and amines having the low melting point as compared to the amino acids and sharp. But melting points of amino acids are very high and oftenly decompose at their melting point. Okay, now let's go for the next property, that's the Zwitter ion. Why these two properties are different as compared to the amines and carboxylic acids? So this is due to the Zwitter ion form. So Zwi means two, so that is the German word, that's the Zwi. So the species which consist of two oppositely charged ions called as Zwitter ion. So amino acids will exist in Zwitter ionic form. So it will have two oppositely charged ion, that means a cation and anion. Then let's see how that Zwitter ion is formed in amino acids. So suppose we have this particular amino acid structure, general structure of the amino acid. So it is uncharged, there is no any charge. So here if you see, amino acid consists of amino as well as acid group. So internal acid base reaction will take place. So this amino group will picks up this proton. So there is a formation of NH3+. And what's remaining here? Carboxylate ion. So there is a formation of this particular species which consists of the two oppositely charged ions, negative and positive, and that's why this is a Zwitter ion, and it is also called as a salt like structure. Okay, so generally salts have the very high melting points and water solubility, and that's why amino acids are showing the water solubility as well as high melting point. Okay, so this is about the Zwitter ionic form of the amino acid. Next property is the amphoteric nature of amino acids. So amino acids can act as an acid or base. It will show the both acidic as well as basic behavior. So suppose we have this particular Zwitter ionic form of amino acid, and if you are taking the acidic medium, so what will happen? This negatively charged carboxylate ion will accept the proton. So there is a formation of this particular species. So as it is an acidic medium, so you will have this form, or this product will form. So in acidic medium, that particular carboxylate ion accepting the proton. So here this species is acts as a base because it accepting the proton here. Okay, similarly if you are taking the basic medium, so this particular OH minus will picks up the proton from this ammonium ion or NH3 plus, so you will get the species or the formation of NH2COO minus, as it is the basic medium, so you will get at this particular thing. So in basic medium this species is acts as an acid because it donates the proton. So amino acids can act as an acid as well as base. So this is about the amphoteric nature of amino acid. Okay, so the next property is isoelectric point. Suppose you are taking the amino acid solution, so this is the solution of amino acid and it is placed in an electric field. Okay, so what happens there, depending on the pH of the solution, amino acid will migrate either towards the cathode and anode. We know that we have a amino acid structure like this bitter ionic form. If pH is very high, so at that time bitter ionic form is exist as an anionic form, because pH is very high, it's a basic solution, so base will abstract the proton and amino acid is exist in anionic form. So if it's an anionic form, negatively charged, it will migrate towards the anode. If pH is very low, so definitely the medium becomes the acidic. So at that time this negatively charged anion will be converted into a COH group and you are getting a cationic form. So cation is there, so cation will migrate towards the cathode. So pH of the amino acid solution is very important. Depending on that, it will migrate either towards anode or cathode. But there is a certain pH value of the medium at which amino acid does not migrate towards cathode or anode. So that pH value is nothing but the isoelectric point. So the definition of the isoelectric point is what? The pH value of the medium at which amino acids does not migrate either towards cathode or anode. Okay, all of you are getting what is the isoelectric point. Okay, depends on the nature of the solution, whether it is a acidic or basic. Definitely in acidic medium cationic form is there and in basic medium anionic form is there. And the different amino acids have a different isoelectric points. It depends on the structure of side chain, so that we have seen in general structure. This is particular R group, so this is the side chain. So nature of this side chain decides the isoelectric point. If side chain R is neutral or very weakly acidic or basic, so isoelectric point will be in the range of 5 to 6.5. if R is acidic side chain, so as it is an acidic side chain, definitely pH will be low. If pH is low, definitely isoelectric point also low. If you are taking the basic side chain, so basic side chain pH will be high, so isoelectric points are also high, definitely more than 7, and it's a low, so it's a very much low, so below 3, 2, so like that. So this is about the isoelectric point. Okay, for example, if you are taking the glycine, so glycine has isoelectric point up to glycine has isoelectric point up to 6 pH value. So this migration of amino acids depending on the pH value of the medium can be used in the electrophoresis technique. So it can be used for the separation of the mixture of amino acids. So if you have the mixture of the amino acids, do the electrophoresis, you will get the separate amino acids. So the property of migration of amino acids to either cathode or anode used for the separation of mixture of amino acids is known as electrophoresis. Okay. These all are the properties of the amino acids. Now we'll go for the reactions of the amino acids. So that's a very interesting part. Amino acids undergo different types of the reactions. As it contains both amino as well as carboxylic acid group, it will show both type of the reactions. So first we are going to see the reactions of COOH group, and then we'll see the reactions of the amino group. So first reaction is reaction with the alcohol. So that's the esterification reaction. So suppose you are taking a amino acid in a protonated form and the ethyl alcohol. So it is used for the esterification reaction in presence of a acid. So simply there is a dehydration will takes place. It's like this. Water molecule is eliminated and you will get the formation of ester. So let's show that. So this is about the ester formation. So this, so we are getting the ester of corresponding amino acid. Now let's go for the next reaction, that is reaction with the phosphorus pentachloride. So we are taking the amino acid and PCl5. The role of PCl5 is just convert this OH group into a Cl. So we are getting the corresponding acyl halide of amino acid. So just convert this OH group into a Cl plus, you are getting the side product HCl plus POCl3. Okay, now let's go for the next reaction, that is the reaction with amines. So that corresponding formation of acyl halide or formed acyl halide reacted with the amines. So there is a just elimination of the HCl, so you will get the product is RCONHR. So this is the CONH, it's amide bond, so you are getting the corresponding amide of respective amino acid. So here formed CONH bond. Such CONH bonds are formed in protein formation. So at that time this particular CONH bond is called as peptide bond. So this is called as a peptide bond. So remember this, it's a peptide bond. Okay. Next reaction is the decarboxylation reaction. So amino acids on decarboxylation forms the corresponding amines. If you are taking the histidine and if it undergoes the decarboxylation reaction, so simple removal of this CO2 molecule, so you are getting the corresponding amine histamine. So this particular reaction is occurring in a stomach also. So histidine decarboxylated to histamine, which secretes the gastric juices in stomach. Okay, so this is the decarboxylation. Now we'll go for the reactions of the amino groups in amino acid. So first reaction is reaction with nitrous acid. So HNO2 is the nitrous acid. So I have drawn here the amino acid, and amino acid on reaction with nitrous acid, so just there is a replacement of this NH2 group by OH. So you are getting the alpha hydroxy carboxylic acid. So this is the one of the important reaction to obtain the alpha hydroxy carboxylic acids. Okay, now let's go for second reaction, is reaction with 1-fluoro-2,4-dinitrobenzene. So amino acids when reacted with a 1-fluoro-2,4-dinitrobenzene, so amino group will react with this phenyl ring, so HF is just eliminated to form a condensation product. So you will get here C2,4-dinitrophenyl derivative, which is yellowish in color. Next reaction is reaction with diencyl chloride. So diencyl chloride has this structure, so naphthalene ring is attached to N dimethyl group, and this is the sulfonyl chloride group. This is the amino acid, so which will react with the diencyl chloride. So simple HCl molecule is eliminated here, and you are getting at this particular derivative, that is the diencyl amino derivative. So you are getting at this particular compound, which shows a fluorescence. Okay, now let's go for the fourth reaction, that is the reaction with the phenyl thioisocyanate. So this is the phenyl thioisocyanate, and this is the amino acid group. So instead of OH, I have written here R dash. This R dash may be OH or protein part. Suppose this is a protein, so it can react with the phenyl thioisocyanate. So how the reaction is going? So first, the lone pair present on nitrogen is attacks on the carbon, so as to this C double bond N is open, so it becomes N minus, and this N minus will picks up the proton from this nitrogen. So you are getting at this particular intermediate compound. Okay, now this intermediate compound will undergo cyclization in presence of acid. It will undergo the cyclization. So simple, this particular R dash S is eliminated, so simply this particular thing will be occur here. So this nitrogen attacks on the carbonyl, and this R dash is eliminated, so R dash and H, so this will be removed as a side product. You will get this N phenyl thiohydantoin as a product. So this is about the reaction with the phenyl thioisocyanate. Okay, now let's go for the next reaction. The last reaction is the reaction with nenhydrin, one of the important reaction. So amino acids, when reacted with the nenhydrin, that is the oxidized form of the nenhydrin, it will undergo the deamination and decarboxylation reaction. So it's a simple, this carbon dioxide is eliminated as well as deamination. So this H and this NH2, so ammonia and CO2, it will be eliminated. This nenhydrin supplies the oxygen to this alpha carbon, and this part is converted into aldehyde. So you are getting the aldehyde, ammonia and carbon dioxide. And as this nenhydrin supplies the oxygen, it gets reduced here. So you are getting this particular reaction. Now this oxidized form and reduced form of the nenhydrin complexes with the ammonia to form a colored product, that's the violet color product. So how that violet color is formed? So I have drawn here nenhydrin, that is the oxidized form. So this is the structure of the nenhydrin oxidized form. So it's just like a phthalic anhydride part. Here instead of the oxygen, carbon, and this carbon is joined to two hydroxyl groups. And the reduced form, just one oxygen is removed here. So you are getting the nenhydrin reduced form and the ammonia. So these three compounds, they will complexes with each other. So simply there is a dehydration reaction takes place. So this water molecule here, also this water molecule is eliminated, and third water molecule is eliminated here. So three water molecules are eliminated, and you will get the product here like this. So this is the part here you are getting. So phenyl ring, these two carbonyl groups, here is a formation of C double bond N, because here the two water molecules are eliminated. Carbon is joined to nitrogen through a double bond, and that's why you are getting this double bond here. Here also this carbon loses the hydroxyl group, and hydrogen and nitrogen and carbon is joined through single bonds. You are getting this. And finally, if you see here, I have shown a enol type part here, because when this enolization takes place, this part and this part, they are come in conjugation with each other. This is the extended conjugation, and when extended conjugation is there, so that compounds are colored compounds. If you see here, this ring, then single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond, and again the ring is there. So whole thing is in conjugation there, and that's why it shows the colored products, the violet colored product. So we have seen all type of the reactions of the amino as well as carboxylic acid group. I hope all of you understand these all reactions. If you understand this, please like the video and subscribe and press the bell icon button so you'll get the notification of the next video. Okay, thank you very much. Best of luck.